Welcome to That's Good Sports. I am Brandon. I'm going to stick my neck out there and say that Davis Mills will not be replacing Tyrod Taylor anytime soon. Perna. That's not even a knock on Davis Mills. Nobody wants him to be good more than me. I feel like next to my new Teddy Roosevelt shirts, now available link below, I could sell a Mills worth of General Mills shirts. Unfortunately, Davis Mills plays for the Texans, who have an atrocious offensive line, and I fear he will be hurt way before Tyrod Taylor is even healthy. And all he'll be known for is having a neck as long as Mike Glennon's. Which, by the way, should probably be a quarterback measurable you start tracking at the NFL Combine. Slow 40 times, small hands, and oh no, this man's neck is longer than 30 inches. Let's move him to free safety and see if he can become the next Merton Hanks. Hanks would have had a more successful career had he not been so ashamed of his neck, hiding it in a turtleneck every chance he got. Anyway, today on this show, we're talking about more than necks. We've got some football to get through. Some news from Carolina's win last night over the Texans. I got good news for Browns fans. Very good news. And an update on officiating, plus ESPN's Manning cast, Carson Wentz might play this weekend. Holy crap, it's a big NFL Friday news dump. It's good sports. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel. I need you to. Today's episode is sponsored by HelloFresh. Go to HelloFresh.com and use my code THATSGOODSPORTS14 to get 14 free meals plus free shipping. Now that football season is underway, I am busier than ever, which is why I rely on HelloFresh and their quick 20-minute meal options so that my routine is never disturbed. I've got 70-hour work weeks plus a one-year-old running around the house, so HelloFresh protects my blind side by saving me time and money, allowing me to keep my routine and my wife and I fed. One reason I really love HelloFresh is because it gives me new ideas for meals I've made many times. We did burgers this week, and HelloFresh's special sauce house burger was a huge hit. Just don't confuse the mini vinegar bottles for shooters. That was just one of 50 menu options, and I get the family size from HelloFresh, so I have leftovers, saving even more time and money. The 5-star recipes are printed out and are super easy to read and follow, and everything is pre-portioned, so you're not wasting food. Again, go to HelloFresh.com and use my code THATSGOODSPORTS14 for 14 free meals across 5 boxes plus free shipping. Okay, I've complained enough about the taunting rules, but I am happy. I'm sick of complaining about the taunting rules, okay? But I am happy. I am happy that the league fined Andy Dalton for not letting DJ Reader suck his dick here. Who the hell are you, Andy, to turn down a mid-game blowy? Kirk Cousins? Now the NFL reinstated wide receiver Josh Gordon, and he could play as soon as next week. Flash Gordon is still listed as a member of the FCF Zappers. That's the fan-controlled football league. Gordon is a free agent, and he has a new agent, and I am wondering where he will sign. My gut says the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, because Tom Brady is a wide receiver whore now. Plus, Josh Gordon played decently when he was with Tom in the Pats. The team that could use him the most is probably the New Orleans Saints. They need some sort of threat in the passing game without Michael Thomas and Traquan Smith, who's on IR. Fuck it, the only NFC South team that doesn't need Josh Gordon might be the Panthers. Josh Gordon certainly is no Julio Jones, but he's the same type of big-bodied receiver that would be a nice complement to Calvin Ridley for the Falcons. And I doubt his former lovers in the Browns or Seahawks come calling, so I predict the Saints. Unless crazy Dan Campbell sneaks in there, as the Lions could use some help in the wide receiving department as well. Okay, here's my good news for the Browns and their fans. Odell Beckham Jr. is finally off the injury report and has been cleared to play. Now, I have no idea how effective Odell will be this weekend. My best guess not Barry. He's returning from an ACL injury, and I feel like this game will be more about getting comfortable for him than torching the Bears' defense. The timing is good, though, because Jarvis Landry is on IR. Odell hasn't been fully healthy, though, for several years. I hope he's good, really good, because I want the Browns to be really good. But I think Odell's best days may be behind him. How sad will it be if Odell Beckham Jr.'s last 1,000-yard receiving season is 2019, when his head coach was Freddie, there's always a fire in my kitchens. The Browns need a healthy, dynamic Odell Beckham Jr., though. Just like I think the offense needed to build an identity without him last season, I think now they have established that identity and they need the deep threat, the home run hitter that Odell can be, back in that lineup. Baker is in a place right now where he knows he doesn't have to target Beckham every play and force balls his way. That was an issue for Baker when Freddie Kitchens was calling the plays. My prediction, circle the Browns-Vikings game on October 3rd for the official Odell Beckham coming out party, which he did reschedule from June 22nd out of respect for Carl Nassib. Now, the poor man's version of Odell Beckham Jr., who's also actually hurt more than Odell, Will Fuller, will get his first action of the season. Ever since Will Fuller signed with MIA, he's been MIA. More MIA than MIA since she released Bad Girls. Oh, live fast, die young, bad girls do it well. Ah, Sookie Sookie, I'm coming in the Cherokee. Okay, so Fuller's back in the lineup, but Jacoby Brissett, he didn't look particularly good last week, but maybe with some prep and having Will Fuller, Devontae Parker, Jalen Waddle to throw the ball to, gives the Dolphins a chance to upset the Raiders. I think that can happen. Now, last night during the Thursday night football broadcast, Highlight Heaven tweeted out this, the best Christian McCaffrey highlight package you will ever see. I will take responsibility, along with Highlight Heaven, for cursing Christian McCaffrey, because shortly after that highlight was posted, Run CMC pulled his hamstring, left the game. He's going to be out for a while, which sucks, because if anything we're going to get you hyped for Christian McCaffrey, it is this highlight package. I would actually like to see the same thing done for, I don't know, whichever of the 49ers running backs are playing. You can't curse that injury-riddled backfield, but instead of a cool animated panther, I want to see an old-timey gold prospector stabbing defenders in the face with their pickaxes. If someone will make that highlight plus animation, I will feature it here and send you some free coffee. Now, Davis Mills may officially surpassed Mike Glennon as the longest neck in NFL history, but his most impressive stat after his first start for the Texans is simply being alive. Davis Mills played the best game you'll ever see from a guy who could be on life support this morning. Now, sometimes you can play so well that you play yourself, in the immortal words of disc jockey Khaled. That was the case for Raiders kicker Daniel Carlson last week. Carlson nailed 4 field goals, helping the Raiders to a road win in Pittsburgh. The only problem, he was going against himself in fantasy football.
I played against myself in fantasy this week in my own like friend group fantasy. And so that was tough because I took a loss. And I definitely contributed to that. But it's fun. I think fantasy is great.
I have something to say to Daniel Carlson. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you for making it really hard to continue to hate the Raiders. When did the Raiders become a team full of guys I root for? Daniel Carlson, Josh Jacobs, Darren Waller, Hunter Renfrow. These are all dudes I legitimately like. Why couldn't Antonio Brown have stayed on their roster so I had an enemy? As a Broncos fan, I will never like the Raiders, but damn, these men are making me see them as respectable human beings and not just objects I could talk shit at. Now, are traditional broadcasts on the hot seat? Well, they might be, at least on Monday nights. Joe Papalalea tweeted out this, that the Manning cast on ESPN2 and ESPN Plus drew in 1.86 million viewers during the Lions-Packers game last Monday. More than double the viewers they got week one. Now, I'll attribute that ratings jump to a few things. First, they actually know where to find the Manning cast now. Everyone made it seem like you had to buy ESPN Plus, but really it was on ESPN2. Those are some mixed signals. Second, we learned that the Mannings are really good at their new job, which should come as a surprise to no one. It's an enjoyable experience if you want a different experience. You've got two charismatic people who know the game of football inside and out. And finally, people are getting sick of football by Monday night, and I think they want something different. The Manning cast is a nice change of pace in that regard. I don't think this will be the model going forward because there's only one Peyton Manning, but this will soon become the most popular way to take in Monday night football. Suck it, regular broadcast crews. Now, there was not a single challenge by a coach in week two. I'll take that as a sign that means the officials were perfect. Moving on. Okay, in all seriousness, officiating has been bad this season. But it's bad in terms of calls you can't challenge. Things like pass interference, holding, and of course, the worst of all, taunting. If coaches were allowed to challenge taunting, the fields would run red with challenge flags. And honestly, some official somewhere should have thrown a penalty flag on David Culley for trying to choke the life out of Davis Mills on the sideline. Finally, Carson Wentz might play Sunday. Here's where the Colts are as an organization. They're currently debating whether or not to play a quarterback that even with two healthy ankles, nobody knows for sure if he's any good in Carson Wentz, or to play the guy they drafted in Jacob Eason. Or they thought about starting their practice squad QB Brett Hundley. I've done nothing but praise Frank Reich and Chris Ballard the last few years. But if you start Carson Wentz or Brett Hundley over Jacob Eason, I don't think I can defend you. Oh, breaking news, Jacob Eason will start if Carson Wentz does not. So they made that decision. Let me reset the fire alarm here. Maybe Brett Hundley was getting first team reps just in case. Just in case he's got to go in. Carson Wentz will actually be a game time decision. I'd recommend the Colts look at Christian McCaffrey as a cautionary tale here. During the Thursday Night Football broadcast, they said the Panthers coaches wanted to limit McCaffrey because of injury concerns. McCaffrey did not want to be limited. And they didn't. And now he's injured again. If Wentz had just one sprained ankle, I'd say, okay, fine, go for it. I know it's a game time decision against the Titans. I know being 0-2 is a desperate spot to be in. But here's a newsflash. The AFC South is a dumpster fire. And not even a fun dumpster fire. Like the one if you stand close to has some chemicals burning in it and you're gonna get a nice little high going on. No, no, this is the kind of dumpster fire that's just burning a pile of manure. Your best chance to compete for the division is to keep Carson Wentz healthy. Play the long game here, okay, Colts? And roll with Jacob Eason for four quarters for a game. Maybe he'll surprise you. Maybe Carson Wentz will be better if he's got at least one damn ankle that works. Thanks for watching That's Good Sports. Please subscribe here on YouTube. If you don't want to do that, then you probably didn't watch this whole episode. So thanks. Thanks for sticking around. Wow. I love you.